points in particular regarding what I see as a deterioration in the human rights situation in Sudan since the Council last considered the situation in September 2017. The first point I would highlight the continuing attacks on civilians by the rapid support forces in Darfur, especially in the Jebel Mara mountains. The civilian population continues to bear the brunt of violence, which has led to the burning down of villages, causing a number of civilian injuries and death, and the displacement of thousands of people. And in that context, I would also add that it's unacceptable that the government of Sudan has repeatedly prevented UNAMID and humanitarian actors from accessing areas of conflict. I think in my own view, instead of discussing the further downsizing of UNAMID, the UN Security Council should be focusing instead on how to enable UNAMID to deliver its protection of civilians mandate more effectively. Secondly, I would highlight, as a sign of the deterioration of the situation, the arbitrary arrest and detention of youth activists and opposition leaders and ordinary Sudanese who took part in peaceful protests in Sudan last November and also again in January this year, some of whom were detained for several months and some of whom reported ill treatment while in detention. Thirdly, we have seen continued restrictions on the Sudanese media and reports of confiscations of newspapers that publish articles critical of the regime. And we have heard that there is a new draft press law which would extend these restrictions to the electronic media. And fourthly, and I think it's important to also to be aware of the restrictions on economic and social rights for the Sudanese public. In that context, the government of Sudan spends over 70% of its national budget on the military and security sector, and only a tiny percentage, around 2% of its budget, on health, education, and other basic services, thereby limiting the economic and social rights of the Sudanese people. These are just four examples, and there are many other issues that we could mention. As several of the other speakers have already stressed, I think it's also important to recognise that there is no accountability. As one other speaker mentioned, for example, there is a state of emergency in several areas of Sudan. So it is clear to me that the human rights situation in Sudan does not belong in a technical assistance and capacity building resolution under item 10. The situation belongs rather under item 4 and requires a special rapporteur. Finally, I would just add that unlike other country situations, the human rights situation in Sudan, I believe, only comes to the Council once a year in September. An issue for consideration is whether the Human Rights Council could consider having an enhanced interactive dialogue in one of its other sessions in addition, so that the Council could be updated more frequently on the human rights situation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.